course it's scheduled to restart in 30 minutes. Chase, how are you, buddy?
Better make them guns.
doing more gun making than you do. Should get in and help, Noah. Wakey, wakey. We made $1,500 yesterday, Noah. You ain't home, you never home. What are you out doing? You get paid every hour. What do you mean? Welcome in, everyone. Welcome in. Yeah, okay. Oh, someone shoot. They just bought you a whole horse. What do you mean? Just bought you a horse.
Thank you. I be sleeping with the 45 like every night. In the whip, I pray to God I don't see flashing lights. God damn, they right behind me. And I wake up every day. I wake up every day with this anxiety.
See if they're around.
Look at who it is.
Howdy there, how are you?
Mr. Gunsmith.
Yes, how are you?
How nice to meet you. Lovely. Alexander should also wake up. He passed out during the storm.
Oh, okay. Is he coming back here?
Yes. Perfect. He's actually there on the floor in case you cannot see him.
Oh, perfect.
Sleeping.
Yeah. Good for him. He could use a nap or two. Do what?
Yeah. What was your name?
My name's David. David McCarthy.
David. Yes, David. Sorry, I forgot. Yep. Really bad with names. You can ask her.
That's okay.
I forgot her name for like the first 3 days I knew her.
That's all right. How have you guys been?
All right. Okay. I killed some panthers earlier. Got attacked by. Got into a wrestling match with a bear yesterday. It shot it in the head and it was laying on top of me for 30 minutes. I was just stuck there.
What kind of hunting are you doing?
Sport hunting. It's just for fun.
Well, if you need a better gun, just let me know. Fuck.
Who stole his clothes? Jesus. Yeah. I actually really like my Lichenfield.
Well, good. As long as it gets the job done for you, it's all that matters.
However,
did I just hear Alexander?
Yeah, he's naked.
Yeah, he's upstairs.
Are you guys able to do any work on guns, like paint them and stuff?
No, not yet. We're waiting on our parts to come in.
Oh, I have a chicken to skin with you. What the shit is up with those knives? I bought one earlier.
He's not the blacksmith, he's the gunsmith.
Okay, but maybe he knows, like, what the shit is up with the knives, because... Look at this knife. I mean, did I get scammed? Because it looks just like the normal one. Like, yeah, this is the one I bought, and this is the normal one, and I paid, like, I don't know. What the shit?
Yeah, the knife you bought, I just keep the normal ones in the shop.
Oh, look at this one. I also bought this one. Isn't it beautiful? This
one's nice. No, yeah.
Like a dagger.
Very nice.
Alright. Anyhow, would you mind if I talk to Alexander for a moment? Because I have to go to bed.
Yeah.
And then afterward, you guys can do your business.
Alright, yeah. Sounds good. I'll stay back.
How you doing, pal?
Good, how are you? You didn't seem happy. Welcome in, welcome in. We're waiting to talk to Alexander here at the Bastille. Got some information for him. Hopefully he'll be done soon. Never noticed a sign here. When did I get there? Put the trolleys in. It's new.
Okay, then I have a question.
Not only that, too many guns get out there, we're going to have to start robbing all the guns to control the supply and demand.
Oh my god, you're so sad.
I know.
Huh? Oh no. Anyhow. So, we are the only ones that can make, like, the Navy crossover?
Yeah, we're the only ones that take coats and...
Okay. Why? The others don't have the password or what?
Nobody does. And we're the only one who is still first to mention.
Oh, that's
I
great.
Do believe there was another family somewhere out in the Austin or something that had the knowledge to mention, but I do believe they're gone.
Yeah, even if they come back, we just let's believe them or something. Anyhow, I think the password should be a bit more complicated, to be honest.
Well, I'll be honest with you, the password has changed about 8 times.
Oh, okay, that's good. How do we know the new one, then?
I think it's that guy, I think so.
Yeah, we just told by him what the new guy.
Out. What was it, Harry? Thank you.
I said good night. Oh, look what you did, Jeff. Okay. I gotta find David.
No, he's here.
Man, I didn't leave.
You are very patient.
Keep you waiting, David.
Oh, no, you're fine. You wanna go talk upstairs?
Yeah. Offense. I had a meeting room here.
Yeah, it'd be nice. I'll make sure I'm whispering here.
So, how are things?
Oh, things are well. Things are well. How's your things?
Sure you've heard Wick turned himself in.
I've not heard, actually. How long is he away for?
Till his court date, until they decide to try and swing him.
You know, I think it's real bullshit that right after we had that conversation and then that dumbass came around me, magically Perseus's bounty went up.
Wait, what happened?
You know, I seen Perseus's bounty, it went up to 5,500.
Oh.
For the same charges.
I saw that. It seems Perseus is a bit jealous.
No, I would agree. But I don't know Perseus that well, so he just seems like the jealous type to me, to be honest.
I thought he got caught.
Did he?
Oh. Well, good.
But it looks like the bounty was taken down.
No. Oh. Mm. The last time I looked, it was still up. It was 5,500, but that was a day or two ago.
Yeah, Perseus is a bit of the jealous type. Always has to be the best.
Huh.
I think it stung him a little bit.
I can see that. Did you see Pat Bennett walk out of your saloon while ago?
No.
No, yes, he was in here. I was standing outside, he walked by me and said, "How you doing?" I said, "Good."
Oh, was that Bennett?
That was Bennett.
I did see him.
So the information I gave you, what do you think about it?
Oh, about the Italians.
The Italian, that fucking lawyer. Or whatever, the district attorney, or whatever the fuck he is.
I will tell you, that information is priceless.
You know, I kind of walked into that information. I woke up from the storm there, and they came in, and they were like, "Hey, let's go play poker." It's like, okay. You remember that gentleman I was telling you about the other day that jumped on the back of my horse?
I do believe so.
Yeah, it was him. So he approached me after the storm and was like, "Hey, let's go play poker." And I was like, "Okay, like, do you want to go to the casino boat or, like, what do you want to do?" And there's a bunch of people with him. I was like, "Sure." He was like, "Oh, we can just break in upstairs." And I was like, "You're a fucking district attorney. You shouldn't be breaking into people's houses to go play fucking poker. Because, you know, we have that parlor above our gun store." Well, what he doesn't know either is that I'm very good friends with the people that live upstairs, obviously. Because it's Edward and Willie. Well, as we were... I knew Willie was up there. So I took him up there and started walking up there. And Willie was coming down the stairs. So we went back in, blah, blah, blah. So I'm sitting there and I'm like, "So what's your name again?" Told me his name, cool, whatever, and I kind of let it go, and then the old Italian guy, whoever owns the fucking boxing ring here in town, was sitting there too, and I was like, "Well, what's your name?" He told me his name, and I was like, "Well, what do you do?" And he was like, "Oh, I own the boxing rink, whatever, blah, blah, blah." Well, how this conversation got started was Willie was like, "Hey, I'm gonna go get some food," or whatever, and I was like, "Okay, cool," and he got back, and I was like, "Did you go to the Bastille?" He's like, "No, I went to whatever the fuck this other saloon is here in town that nobody fucking goes to. The hole in the wall." He went there. And I was like, "Well,
Doyle's, yeah.
Boys. Yeah, Doyle's." I was like, "Well, you should have went to the Bastille. Normally they have a better option and, you know, the prices are sometimes a little better. And he's like, well, and then oh short shit over there started running his mouth. I was like, well, what's your problem with the Bastille? He's like, well, I want the Bastille. It's like, what do you mean you want it? He's like, I'm gonna get it. It's like, oh really? At this point, he has zero idea of my relationship to you guys whatsoever. So I'm like, oh, like, well, what's your problem with the current owners? Blah, blah, blah. And then the Italian guy jumped in, and he was like, well, they tried to do this to Jimmy, blah, blah, blah. And wouldn't tell me what exactly you did to this fucking Jimmy guy.
Do you want to know what I did to Jimmy?
I want to know.
We took Jimmy out on a few jobs with us, and Jimmy got himself arrested because he's a terrible shot and he can't follow orders. That's what we did to Jimmy. We took him out on a few jobs.
Well, they blame you all for that, and I think that's part of the reason. Humorous. So what else kind of caught my eye was that this lawyer guy was really hanging around with these Italians. So I think that's kind of where our sources are coming from the Italians on the outside into the DOJ there. Are all coming from him. And I think they're after your Bastille because he wants it.
The odd thing is now, I was just informed that the Italians don't want the Bastille anymore because they're opening a restaurant. So I'm not really sure what the Italians are after.
I think they might still want it. Maybe they want it.
Well, here's the thing. Gordo, Luca.
Sorry, wrong muscle.
Gordo, Luca, Sammy, all of them. They're all working together. They're all one big Italian family from what I've gathered. Julius and I went and had a meeting at their mansion one day, and he more or less said, how would you like to make a bunch of money for simply keeping your mouth shut? Nothing ever came of it, of course, but those few words speak volumes.
Interesting.
But the fact that Gordo can't even confront us if they truly do blame us for Jimmy, I find humorous, but it does explain why the DOJ was pushing for the Bastille so hard.
Yeah, it's because he wants it.
And I see the Italians talking with the DOJ quite frequently, so I wonder if Gordo whispered into one of their ears.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised. I just think it's all pretty fucking shady, in my opinion.
Oh, it is. I wouldn't trust those Italians as far as I can throw them.
So what's the deal with your buddy, I guess. I mean, what is the verdict? I mean, I know he's in jail, but did they say anything to him? Have you talked to him?
I haven't heard a thing, but the only thing I do know is he's going to remain in Sisica until his court date. But
they made him a deal saying that they weren't going to tie him, like they weren't going to hang him, but who knows if they'll honor that.
So life in prison, then.
Yeah, they said they'll try to get rid of that too, but they can't make any guarantees.
So. Bullshit, they can. They're the fucking DOJ itself. They can do whatever the fuck they want.
I know. We'll probably have to take him out.
But I guarantee they want him to flip on somebody in order to take it off the table.
Huh.
Regardless of what happens, Wick won't ever talk, so. And I sure as hell know he's not gonna rot away in Sisica. Yes, we simply have to wait until we receive word from our lawyer on what is happening. In the meantime, business as usual.
I just find it all kind of shady. Do you guys have anyone like representing you in the DOJ? Or do you guys have a lawyer?
We do. Even though I haven't decided if I trust her yet.
Who is it?
Evelyn Deloney.
Oh.
Yeah, believe me, I've been cautious since I met the woman. She claims her brother wants to kill her and she wants nothing to do with him, but who knows if that's simply in order to save her own ass.
Yeah, we'll I find it pretty suspicious.
Gets him a better deal, and I suppose she's worth it, but if she decides to drop us as clients, then that means she may, in fact, be a lot closer to Perseus than we thought.
So let me tell you my thought here, and you can tell me it's a stupid-ass idea if you want. So I've considered becoming a lawyer, leaving my store to my brother. Maybe you guys could be my clients as well. My goal might be to work up to a judge, stop this corruption bullshit within the DOJ, make sure you guys keep the Bastille, things are supposed to go how they're supposed to go. Not sure how I feel about it yet. How I feel about giving away the store.
Well, I do know the Bastille is safe and sound for now. My brother made a deal with, what the hell's his name? Who's that deputy that, from the swamps?
Oh, Santos.
Santos, yeah. Jesus Christ. Keep forgetting everybody's names. My brother made a deal with Santos. The Bastille is safe and sound as long as he stays out of St. Denis. And essentially, Yvonne cuts ties with Wick. Which won't happen, but they don't need to know that.
I think the DOJ should cut ties with the Italians. I mean,
I think so as well.
How in the fuck are you going to represent or befriend a fucking gang as a part of the DOJ? And that's what I don't understand.
Oh, hell. Did you know one of the Jamesons is a lawyer?
Excuse me.
Yes. I believe Colton Jameson.
Yeah. Isn't he a lawyer? The fat guy?
I believe so. And you then you have Evelyn Deloney as a lawyer, who is Perseus's sister.
You know what this sounds like to me? Sounds like to me every member of a gang is just trying to get a lawyer on their side.
That's exactly what's happening.
So why don't we do the same for you?
It's not a bad idea. Did you change your mind about joining us then?
Not necessarily. I mean, this is how I look at it, because I thought about that as well. You know, you got all these gangs. You can't tell me that Jameson doesn't run around with the gang or is a part of the gang, you know?
Oh, Jamesons are a gang.
I know. That's what I'm saying. They have someone in their family and that's a lawyer. You mean to tell me that individual doesn't run around with them? That's how I see it.
Well, I mean, let's see. You have Colton Jameson's a lawyer. You've got Sammy, whatever the fuck his name is, the Italian, as a bounty hunter.
So you mean to tell me they aren't being shady everywhere? Because to me, that's what it looks like. They're just being fucking shady everywhere.
It definitely is. I would say my family is the only true criminals and outlaws in McAllister.
I'd have to agree.
Well, as much as I hate to say it, perhaps. And see, that's what I respect.
When people have a code and not rules, but they have morals that they live by. These people that are halfway, they don't. The Italians, they don't. They just take and they just want power. They don't have any rules that they live by. They don't have any code. They don't have any morals.
You know what gets you power, Jack? Codes and morals.
I know. And pissing on people's heads.
Respect. That's how you get power.
Yeah.
It's why Perseus has none.
He's literally zero.
He's the enemy of all of McAllister. Therefore, he has no power because there is no one that has his back. Perhaps save for the Jamesons. Oh, I feel Perseus would stab them in the back. First chance he got if he needed to. Me, on the other hand, I see clearly the benefits of having friends. Benefits of respect. Goes a long way, even as a criminal.
Mm-hmm. See, it's funny. We probably have more morals and more of a code And any DOJ, any lawman, any person on the other side of the law.
Well, the difference between us and the DOJ is one simple thing. I, and I'm sure a few of the other boys, understand that the law is simply doing their job. We don't hate them for this reason or that reason. The law that does their job the way they're supposed to do it, we respect it. However, there are laws that do not feel the same way about us, where lowlifes, scum, deserve to be killed, hung. Those are the ones we don't respect, and those are the ones that get what's coming to them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think the corruption starts there with those guys. I mean, I think they're trying to do a decent job of trying to get rid of that corruption. But at the same time, look at this attorney, district, whatever the fuck he is. I mean, he literally got fired from all for corruption two or three weeks in. Hell.
Half of the DOJ rides around with their guns out like they are law.
Yeah, it's a bunch of shit.
And then you've got people like Cody Stone. Too big for her britches, if you ask me. Uses the bounty hunters as personal guards. Attack dogs. They skirt the law and get away with it. They're the biggest criminal organization in McAllister.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But
I would say the choice is yours whether you wish to become a lawyer or not. Don't let my opinion sway you.
Well, the only reason I'd become a lawyer would be to protect you all. That'd be the only reason. Maybe pick up some clients here and there, but it would be strictly for you all. You know, I'd be at your beck and hand whenever you needed something. If you needed out of something, I'd be there for that. You know, that's how I see it. Like, you guys are my main clients. You guys are the ones I would attend to 90% of the time. Because I see you guys as family. You know, that's kind of where I stand.
I like you, David. I've met you twice, but I like you.
Thank you.
I do think that's a good idea.
I'm just here for you. That's the biggest thing. You know, I told you I wanted to help, and I would find every way I could to help you, and here I am. You know, do I want to give up the gun store? Not necessarily. But at the same time, if you need help, that's what I'm here for. You know, and I can always leave.
Sure, you have to give up the gun store to become a lawyer.
I'm not sure on that. It's something I would need to ask.
What about your brother? Did he decide against becoming a bounty hunter?
No, he hasn't. He just hasn't been awake, I don't think. I need to get with him. Oh, shit. I need to get with him and see if when he plans on waking up to pursue that.
Yeah, I mean, as far as everything goes right now with Wick turning himself in, it's not of the utmost importance anymore, but still useful information to have. Know who to watch out for, who to trust.
So why did he turn himself in? That's what I want to know. Like, why?
He was offered a deal by Evelyn. And I think the conscience of, if he turns himself in now, we can deal with the problems we have. If we continue to fight, then he most certainly will swing.
That's fair.
Ultimately, I left the choice up to him.
So he hasn't wrote you at all from jail?
Not that I've gotten, but he's never been much for telegrams, at least to me.
Fair enough.
I know he's been in contact with our lawyer, most likely my brother. But as far as I'm aware, we haven't even heard anything about this court date yet.
Do you guys want to move this into the hallway over there? There's a guy downstairs, just a bit suspicious, just in case. So if we do need to go, we can. Out that way. We don't get cornered.
Do you want to go outside or you want to stay here?
He is fine.
So, I mean, it would be nice to be able to be a lawyer and keep the gun store, maybe do the lawyer import on the side. I mean, I do have a history of law, and I've been in law before, and I have a pretty good understanding of how shit's supposed to work. I feel like how they're doing it here in McAllister isn't the way it's supposed to work, and it seems a little shady to me, and I'm not a fan. But two can play shady, and that's all I can say. If they want to be shady, I'll be shady too, and I'll make sure it benefits us.
Well, I wouldn't be opposed to it, if that says anything. Right now, I mean, Evelyn hasn't really given me a reason not to trust her, but the fact that she's a Deloney could go either way.
Yeah. That's for sure. I don't have a reason not to trust her either. I don't really have a problem with her either. I just, I kind of watch myself and make sure that what I'm saying doesn't get out to people I don't trust, that's for sure.
Well,
kind of like that jackrabbit at the table the other night.
Depending on what we tell Evelyn, she could very easily be running off to Perseus telling him everything that we do.
That's true. I don't know how I feel about that. Especially if you're going to be a lawyer, you can't be interacting with another gang if you represent a gang.
Well, hell, you can be interacting, but I do believe you should keep your mouth shut, as you shouldn't be telling one client things from another client.
Yeah, it's client confidentiality.
But unfortunately, when your last name is Deloney and your brother is a psychopath, hard to tell how much information and how deep the roots of the family actually grow.
Yeah. Well, my offer's on the table. You know, if you guys would feel more comfortable with me taking up that role, I'd be down for it. I'd want to make sure that my gun store stays in the family, though. That's the biggest thing. Even if one of your brothers wanted to take it over, mine didn't. You know, that's kind of where I stand. I don't want to see the gun store go to anyone else. But I also don't want to see we get fucked over in the end, too.
I would say if you decide to venture down that road, we'll gladly take you on as our lawyer. But make sure your gun store is safe and secure before you decide on that.
Yeah, for sure. You know, that's what's important. That's my moneymaker right now, so... You know, if
me,
I could keep the gun store.
That's our moneymaker as well.
Yep. So if I could keep the gun store and keep us in business, keep you in business, that's what I'm here for. But I also want to make sure that you're not going to go fucking swinging over some bullshit that got made up down the way. You know, that's the biggest thing.
And I'm sure, as I said, the DOJ is simply trying to make a point with Wick. Not so much that he's done anything to warrant hanging over it, but the DOJ wants to set an example.
An example for what? That's why I don't understand. What the fucking kind of example are you going to set? Don't do crime, you're going to hang? What kind of fucking example is that set? You know,
exactly.
People like Perseus don't give a fuck.
Well, and that's just it. You've got people like Perseus who escaped from the law countless times, commit just as heinous of acts. Yet I don't see the DOJ chasing him down, taking everything he has, and trying to swing him for it.
Just a heads up, there's a bunch of people downstairs.
Like, how many's a bunch?
More than six.
What do they look like? They look like trouble, or...?
Old guys. I'm not sure yet. I mean, I'm just giving you a heads up. Maybe move the conversation around back, but it's up to you.
Well, that's where I stand. You guys just tell me what you need, and that's what we'll do.
As I said, secure your assets first. Make sure it's the right move for you to make if you decide to make it. Let me know, and we'll get rid of Evelyn and take you on.
For sure. I'll let you know and keep you updated. You know, maybe my brother might find his love for bounty hunting. I don't know. Maybe he'll want to be a lawyer with me. I'm not sure. But if that's the case, then two of us working for you would be wonderful for our pockets and yours.
Well, if that's the case, I would definitely find somebody trustworthy to take that gun stuff.
100%.
Even perhaps William and...
Edward, yeah. We've talked about it already, if it came to that. I kind of got my ducks in a row before I brought this to your attention, so...
Yeah.
I didn't want to...
a gun store owner that we can trust is much more useful than a blacksmith.
100%. But both would benefit you as well. And I think I could probably talk William into doing it. Surely I could talk him into doing it. If my brother didn't want to.
Well, blacksmiths are useful, but only to an extent. Once you have what you need from a blacksmith, the profits tend to dry up.
Yeah.
Gun stores, however, everybody always needs a gun.
Always. I'll tell you what, I've sold a fuck ton of guns these last few days.
Well, I'll tell you, I've got to work on fulfilling my other order with Valentine. But we're going to make a run tomorrow to acquire some more parts, so whatever we have left over, I'll make up for you.
Sounds wonderful. And I'll keep my ear open, see if I learn anything else. That district attorney or whatever doesn't know who... He knows who I am, but he doesn't know my affiliation with you either, so... See, he's kind of loose lips. He likes to say what he wants and doesn't really care who hears it, to be honest. And,
yeah, I've noticed that about him. He's probably one of my least favorite Italians, if I had a favorite.
The problem is he didn't even strike me as Italian, is the thing. He just struck me as an idiot, to be honest.
He is an idiot. Doesn't know how to keep his damn mouth shut either.
All I'm going to say is he's lucky there were some Italians sitting around the table because it took a lot out of me not to put a bullet in his forehead and call it a day. So.
The fact that his family blames us for what happened to Jimmy is quite humorous, honestly.
Oh, 100%. I chuckled a little when I said that.
The fact that Jimmy went on two jobs with us and... his dumbass went and took a marshal hostage. He deserved what he got.
Yeah. Play stupid games, win stupid prizes.
That's what I say. Besides, why the hell should I be responsible for Jimmy? He knew the risk.
Exactly. It's not your fucking problem.
Perhaps his family shouldn't have abandoned him, forcing him to come with us. Regardless.
Well, I don't think his family's the brightest either. I mean, they haven't really shown me that they're intelligent, so... Seems to me they're running a real shitty fight club, and they keep posting fucking... their posters on my fucking windows, and we're gonna have an issue.
Yeah, they're putting them up all around town. It's becoming a nuisance.
Well, my store's not for them, so... I don't know who hung some Jesus shit on the other side, but I'm not about that shit either.
Oh, Christ, I saw that. Somebody put one right on the bar downstairs.
Yeah.
What was it?
I don't know, some scripture thing.
Some cult.
I actually think I might have seen the lady that was doing that. She was trying to do it at the telegram station right in front of the teller.
I swear I can't deal with stupid ass people.
Somebody.
So I do have a question for the both of you. Well, maybe both of you. So I'm trying to acquire some sawed-off shotguns. You know anything about that?
As far as I'm aware, the only people that I know of that can even get such a thing would be the pawn shop here in town.
I'll ask Jennifer to see if she knows, because I know she has one.
Well, yeah, I know he's selling them there in the pawn shop.
Yeah, unfortunately, I used to be able to make them, but ever since, whatever happened, all of the benches that I used to construct things at, somebody went around and destroyed everything. So, now, as far as I know, the pawn shop and whoever else might be able to do it. Not hard to do, but just gotta know the right people, I suppose.
Yeah, I might get with the pawn shop. The problem is I think we're awake at different times.
Yeah, I've never seen any of them. As far as I'm aware, they're mostly around in the early mornings.
They're kind of around at random times, especially Reggie. He's usually around in the earlier half of the day, though. Like, 12 to, like, 4.
Well, Jack, if you happen to see Reggie, inquire about them, see what we can do for David here.
Alright. Yeah, I can do that.
I know what you'll need is a double-barrel shotgun and a hacksaw.
I can make about fucking 50 of those right now.
Yeah, ask Reggie if he'd be willing to.
Alright.
I'm sure he'll want some form of payment, but...
Oh, I'm sure. But yeah, just let me know. Shoot me a telegram or whatever.
Been the one thing even Valentine's been asking me about them, but... I was only able to construct them a few times before everything went to shit.
Well, I've been told that Valentine's able to make them. Well, he was able to make them, and then he got locked out of the table.
Yeah, same thing that happened to me.
Interesting.
So, unless there's another one out there somewhere that I'm not aware of, I just have to talk to Reggie.
Sounds good. You know, just let me know if you guys see him before I do. I kind of go over there once a day-ish or so.
Yeah, chances are I probably won't see him. I'm usually not around until a few hours after he's gone. But
yeah, I'll talk to him.
I'm sure Jennifer will be around. Jack will probably be around.
Yeah, just let me know. I can pay you guys too or whatever for the information, so.
Don't worry about it.
Hey, you don't gotta pay us.
But I'll keep my eye open. I'll start kind of inquiring about this lawyer thing. Kind of go from there. Won't pull the trigger again without talking to you again about it, but we'll see. We'll see what happens and where it lands us. You know, like I said, if... you put me on retainer, and I got money flowing in. You're safe. You still got money flowing. That's all I care about. So, the gun store's safe.
Like I said, we'll gladly take you on, but don't do it just for us. It's your life. It's your work.
Well, you know, I can always take on more. I don't mind doing that. Just, you guys would be the main priority, you know?
Of course.
And I'm not sure how my schedule would work with it, too.
For your own benefit, not for ours.
Yeah. Which I've heard there's money to be made. I've heard a lot of people put lawyers on retainers around here, so.
It's always money. You might even be privy to some of this corruption that's going on in the DOJ.
You know, I'd love to expose a lot of them. They'd probably hate me, but I'd probably expose majority of it.
As from what I've heard, Evelyn wanted to expose them too, but not sure how true that is.
Well, I mean, look who she is, you know.
She claims she's nothing like him, but...
Well, it's a Delany, always a Delany is how I see it.
Actions speak louder than words, so we'll see if... what she says is true.
What's that?
That would be a telephone, Jack. Fancy people use them.
Oh, boy. You struggling over there? You see it okay?
Yeah, I'm just... never seen one of these.
Yeah, not many places have them. That's why most people still send telegrams.
Hello.
I don't think anyone wants to talk to you, bud.
It's alright. Fuck him.
But yeah. I mean, from my standpoint, you know, you guys have done a lot for us, and, you know, I'd always like to return that favor if I can.
Yeah, like I said, you decide to go down that road, you let me know.
I will. Well, it's been good talking to you. Hope that information does you well.
Oh, it definitely will. As I said, that information was priceless.
If I see the fella, I don't know. Might bring him to you, let you deal with him if you're around.
Don't do anything too risky. Right now, the biggest issue with the Italians, we're trying to tread lightly because there are so many of them.
It's funny that I only see like two or three at a time. The question is, where the fuck are the rest of them?
That's what I told my brother. There might be a lot, but they're usually not all around at once.
Yeah, I've only ever seen two or three together at a time.
Nah, we'll see what comes of it.
Sounds good. Who knows
if he's even still after the Bastille. If he is, I'll find out and I'll deal with him.
I like it. What's your plans the rest of the day?
Not too sure. Just me and Jack around. Most of my boys have taken a little vacation after Wick turned himself in to clear their heads.
Fair enough.
Hopefully they should be back around in a day or so.
Fair enough. Well, sounds good. You know.
Yeah, I think tomorrow we'll probably head up, pick up some more gun parts. Get some more supplies done. But, yeah, normal business until then.
Well, if you need help, let me know. Yeah.
Do you know anything about a Giovanni O'Pizzi?
Say the name again.
Giovanni O'Pizzi.
The name sounds familiar. Is he not the boxing owner?
I don't think he's the owner of the boxing
club. No, that's Luca Moretti.
There's another one. There's another one, too.
Oh, there's another boxing club or another owner?
No, there's another owner.
I don't think it's him. I do know he runs with the Italians. I was just wondering if you knew anything about him.
No, not on top of my head. Never heard that name. I've heard it once. I think those gentlemen from the other night said his name, but they didn't say who he was or what he does.
The one from the other night, you said?
Yeah, the boxing owner, Luca.
Yeah. Huh.
He said his name, but he didn't say what he did or how he's related or anything like that.
Alright.
There was another gentleman there, another Italian, but I never got his name.
Well, I know Luca Moretti is the boss of all of them, from what I could tell. Then, of course, you've got Tony over here at the barber shop. He's one of them. He also works for the Jamesons, from what I've heard.
I know Pizzi works at the barber shop.
And he probably is one of them. If he works at the barber shop, he's with Tony.
I know he's one of them. The other day, before he was going to go hang out with Jennifer, he went up to the group of the Italians and was like, okay, so you guys go burn Butcher's Creek down. Something like that.
Yeah, that fucking lawyer, he represents everyone at Butcher's Creek. Do you know that?
It's funny, because apparently you said they're going to Butcher's Creek to burn it down and stuff.
Huh.
Well, who knows? Perhaps these Italians are splintered in some way. Two different factions of them, perhaps.
Yeah, I still don't trust either. They're all slippery serpents.
Nah. I don't trust any of the Italians. In one way or another, they are all connected.
I always keep my head on a swivel with them. Always.
I do know the Sombreros really have a bone to pick with the Italians.
That's always good.
Let it be them two, then.
What was that?
So let those two deal with it. I'm not a big fan of the Sombreros either.
Not either. Who's Vito with?
Vito is with himself.
He's not According, Italian, right?
He is Italian, but he's from New Jersey, from what I hear.
Okay, that's good.
Apparently, Luca and the rest of the Italians, from what I heard, told him he needs to act more like an Italian. Apparently, the rest of the Italians are a bit old school. From Italy, and Vito sort of does his own thing, and they don't like that too much.
Vito should make them shut up.
I don't trust Vito as far as I can throw him either. I think he's pretty shady myself.
First time I met Vito, he bought some jewelry off me, but I also made him throw up because I gave him a pig heart.
You gave him what?
A pig heart.
Yeah, I've learned he's kind of a bitch.
You're a strange guy, Jack. You really are. That's okay.
Well, if you guys need anything, just let me know. I'll do what I can, and we'll go from there. I'll talk to my brothers, see what they think about it. Oh.
How much do you guys sell ammo for? And would you guys be willing to do, like, big bulk orders of ammo?
Oh, yeah. You just tell me what you need, and we'll get you a deal. We'll make you pay full price.
What do you charge? Is it $5 a box?
Fuck no. So shotgun ammo is $5. But that's because it's a 1-to-1 ratio. So one copper, one gunpowder makes one box.
No, Lassie's selling, I believe, $2 a box.
Yeah, he's for everything or just for shotgun ammo?
No, I think shotgun's a bit pricier, but yeah. I think revolver and repeat is $2.
So my
I went down to Tumbleweed the other day, and that place is cheap.
Yeah, it's because who the fuck wants to go out there?
Yeah, exactly.
I forgot why I was down there.
My revolver ammo's $2, pistol ammo's $2, repeaters $3, rifles $3, shotguns $5.
Alright. And if we were to buy it in bulk, would that bring it down in price?
Oh, yeah. I'll cut a bigger deal for you guys.
Alright. Good to know. I'll probably talk to you about that soonish.
It won't take me very long. Just let me know what you need. I can have it made up for you.
Yeah, I definitely think depending on how things go, we might put in a very big order.
Yeah, just let me know if you want guns, certain guns. I know you can make some of your own, but whatever guns you need, whether it's rifles or whatever, I'll cut you a big deal. Just let me know. Get it all put away for you.
All right, appreciate that.
You're welcome. Like I said, my rifles are pretty cheap. They're $40 for bolt action, $45 for Springfields, and my varmints are $20. But varmints are dog shit.
How much your rifles are around as much as Tumbleweed sells them for? I think theirs were $42. So that's a good price, considering you're insane to me.
Oh yeah.
I think really the only prices that'll fluctuate is the guns that we supply.
Yep, it'll fluctuate by what you charge me.
Well, from what I've seen, most folks sell them for about $45 a piece, but...
That's what I sell them for.
How much do we sell them for to the source?
With these guys here, I believe $30 a gun.
Oh, I still have... those reinforced lassos too, if you need them.
Yeah, I know we still got that box. Like I said, nobody's really been around, so we'll figure out if we'll be needing that other box.
Well,
if not, just hold on to it for us.
I will. So, just let me know what bulk order you need, whether it's guns or ammo or both, and I'll get you fixed up.
Yeah, I think as far as sidearms go, we can pretty well deal with what we make, but long arms, that's a different story. We could definitely use quite a few.
Well, just let me know what you need, and I'll get it made up for you. I can work on that tonight or tomorrow or whatever.
Perfect. Yeah, like I said, we'll probably do a run here tomorrow night. I've got about... I'm able to make about 15 guns right now, so I should have a bit left over tomorrow, so...
If you need parts, tell me. I can make you parts.
Our parts are a bit different than your parts.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, that would be a blessing.
Well, if there's anything that I can make to help you, just let me know. I'll get it made up for you, too.
Out of curiosity, what is it that you can make?
So I can make, revolver-wise, since that's what you make, revolver cylinders, frames, barrels, triggers, and springs.
We get all of ours are just together.
Yeah, as I said, I didn't think it would help too much. Most of our parts come in a sack, so.
Nah. Fair enough.
Who was that that came in there?
The person that just ran through?
Yeah.
I think it was just someone coming out of their hotel room.
I thought I heard somebody coming upstairs.
Yeah, they, I think it was actually Italian. Seemed to dress like one.
Of course it was.
Interesting. Well.
That is.
I'm gonna, I guess, head to the clothing store and figure out a new outfit, I guess.
Alright.
You guys need something, let me know.
I will do.
If you guys need me to go anywhere with you too, I'm open to that as well. I ain't got shit to do.
Yeah, like I said, tonight, I don't think there's too much in the cards, but tomorrow, quite possibly.
Yeah, it's a middle.
Fucking hate that trolley.
What are you doing? Why's your gun in your fucking belly? Huh? It is.
It's almost run me over 5 times.
Yeah, when that fucking trolley get here?
It's been here on and off for a few days now.
Huh.
Shut the hell up, lady.
I was waiting on Julius to get back, but...
The hell out of here.
He was at the bank. He told me to meet him here, but, yeah.
Julius is in.
Well, he's at the bank, but he's supposed to be coming up this way, but... Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, goddamn trolley's almost hit me about 5 times.
Yeah,
it takes some getting used to there, that's for sure.
It comes barreling around the corner at you.
Yeah, that's true. That is true.
Hello. What's going on? Hey, do any of you know if there's something going on at the courthouse, or is that just lawmen standing over there?
It's probably just lawmen.
Yeah, that's
my guess.
I think it's what I figured. All it is. Or there might be somebody with trying to get some sort of case overturned or something.
It didn't look like lawman.
But I've not seen a judge, so...
Yeah, it didn't look like lawman, but...
Could be bounty hunters.
Oh, I think that's Uncle. Yeah, I think those are bounty hunters. That one looks like Uncle.
Oh, that's the group that came in.
Yeah, they're probably trying to collect on... I know a bunch of those got filled. They're probably trying to get their money.
Yeah, I heard most of them got filled, if not all of them.
Bounty hunters didn't capture anybody, so they shouldn't get any money.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Not surprised. Where'd Jennifer go, Jack?
To sleep.
Right when I think Giovanni's going to wake up soon. Oh, well.
Well, tell her pizza she says hi.
Tell O-Pizza, I will. You should call him O-Pizza.
I will.
You like fist fights? It might cause one.
I love fist fights.
Go call him O-Pizza when you see him.
Alright.
Multiple times. Not just once. And she's got her
for
gun
sure.
out. For some reason.
Yeah, they were just in the Bastille. Sitting there for a little bit. There's the people that came up and talked about.
Interesting.
Y'all heard about them cannibals?
The cannibals?
I've been chased by them twice now.
They took a chunk of my back.
I guess I didn't know I was talking to one in the out in the swamps earlier. Well, I mean, I kind of thought he was, but I'm not one to accuse. You know, I just treat everybody with respect. The next thing I know, he's like, "Oh, you're welcome in the creek anytime."
Oh,
he's
I like, shot at one earlier. You. It was this guy named his last. He was like Grandpa Creek or something. I told him to fuck off and called him a useless, stupid cannibal. And then he
That's
shot at a
lot
snake.
Of fucking people. Jesus. Holy shit.
What the fuck is going on here?
Yeah, those are bounty hunters is what that is. That's that group of bounty hunters of, out of Armadillo.
Oh, the McConaughey's?
Wait, are there multiple groups of bounty hunters?
Yeah, there's a couple of them that I know of, at least.
Jesus Only main Christ. Group I know of is the McConaughey's.
Well, they're more like mercenaries, aren't they? They're just kind of like, they just kind of
think...
do whatever.
I think they went against bounty hunting because they used to indulge and, you know, put their fingers in the underworld as well, so.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you, the bounty hunters ain't, I wouldn't fear them too much.
No, I'm not scared of no bounty hunters.
I got no warrants. They... I got no reason to be scared of bounty hunters.
Even if you do. They're disorganized. They're,
useless.
Couldn't hit the broadside of a fucking barn.
Laugh him in the face and spit in their mouth.
I think that might just be on that one, Jack. At least the spit in the mouth part.
Oh, sorry, spit in their face. My bad. Spitting in someone's mouth, not like a disrespect thing.
Is it strange that all of the bounty hunters look like they'd be bounty hunters?
Right.
You know, it's the same old deal.
Yeah, what is it with the way they fucking dress? Why are they all dressed like they want to stand out?
Twinsies.
Because they're dumbasses.
Hey, if I was a fucking bounty hunter, I would look as inconspicuous as I could.
I'd dress like a businessman.
I'd dress like a local. Shit. You wouldn't be able to tell me between me or a local.
Did you say my brother was at the bank?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was, yeah.
Oh.
Well, maybe his brother's got a bounty.
Uh-oh.
There's no challenge. You've already gotten yourself hurt once. I don't think you want to do it again.
Sadie.
Hey, you say the word. My boys and I'll be coming right after you. How about that? You want us to do a challenge? Let me know anytime, anywhere.
Fuck you. That's the fucking word. Pussy.
I really wanted them to try something. I really wanted to shoot. I was so ready.
Say the word. Were they talking the word, Alexander. We will go
they
shoot them right
shit.
Now.
Julius was talking more shit, though. He was instigating like a motherfucking. I appreciate it.
Say the word. I will. Oh, please. Alexander, say the word.
I heard you were down here, and I realized these were all bounty hunters. I figured I'd come in now.
Almost
sure
through this bad boy.
Don't worry, yo. He was in nice hands.
This shit's ready to go.
I thought it was him saying draw.
Yeah, no, that was me. I was getting ready. I don't sound like that motherfucker at all. I should take that as an insult for that
it
old
was,
son
I did.
Bitch.
I apologize for that, but you I'm know, glad that you were right. ready to shoot.
Oh, I was ready. Any chance I need to shoot a bounty hunter, I'm ready.
Shit, you start beef in St. Denis, you got beef with everybody in St. Denis.
Oh, really? That was some big-ass shootout.
I was going to say, everyone here represents St. Denis. Bounty hunters literally used the Bastille as training drills while we were gone.
That's fucked up. What the hell?
They said they can do it whenever they want. They said they can go in any business whenever they want and take anyone they want. Apparently, they said that. They said the DOJ told them they have every right to.
Then why haven't they put a statement out saying they can?
That I have no clue. They tried to come after Wick.
They told that they could do that, but I'd love to see them actually try to do that.
Wick, yeah, love or hate Wick. They did try. He had the biggest bounty in freaking the state. But he went up to his room, and they pulled guns outside the Bastille, started trying to come through the door. And we told them no, that we'll talk to Wick. They didn't want to hear it. So we all pulled guns and put them down. We did what we had to do. They didn't tell us who they were.
Yeah.
I mean,
fucking bounty hunters.
It would have been worse if they did tell you they were.
So what's the fucking point in them? What, they're here to do the job that law fucking can't, or what? It's like,
well, they're not doing a very good job.
I don't even think they collected any of the bounties that got collected recently, so.
Well, they definitely didn't collect on Wick, that's for sure.
We know the McConaughey's don't do shit, so don't count them in if they even still bounty hunt.
I think they moved to New Austin.
Yeah, that's when I thought they, I heard
they're
they
in Tumbleweed now.
Yeah, that's where they were when I initially heard they were bounty hunting, but then a friend of mine went up and told the Comancheros that they were bounty hunters, and I think they kind of kicked them out of Tumbleweed.
Oh, man, so ready. I wanted to shoot so bad, but I didn't see my brother. Ready. Nobody was there. I was a little,
Hey, don't worry, Phil. I would have got at least three of them, man.
Listen, I had full confidence.
What am I talking about?
I heard you down here, so.
We were all watching them from confidence, the buddy. We were watching all of them.
Hello.
Hello, ma'am. How are you?
If they come back and start, if they bump us one more time, it's.
How you doing? You went in the circle. I'll let you call you,
ma'am.
I'll bark at them.
You'll bark. Okay, Jack, don't do that, please. God.
That's a metaphor. That's a metaphor.
Oh, that's a scary dog.
It's that Jaguar Joe leg dog.
I like that guy. I like that guy.
You know. The Jaguar dog.
Jaguar dog.
Don't be talking about the Jaguar dog.
So like what's going on?
The Jub Jub bird.
Oh, the bounty hunters were, well. Yeah, the bounty hunters instigated. They almost tried to shoot me.
I mean, you were ushering them along a little bit, though.
I did, 100%.
I respect it, though. I wanted
now
to
I just
shoot
know.
Too.
I just needed to know what they all looked like up close and personal. Now I do.
They all look like a bunch of old cunts.
They look like how you'd expect them to look like.
They don't dress all flamboyantly
like
and nice.
They showered.
They have no showmanship.
I was telling everybody like at the Bastille. That they all dress like you would expect the fucking bounty hunter to dress.
Yeah.
Poor and poor. Shitty.
Very not inconspicuous.
They all look like their brother is their mother, poor. And their mom is their cousin, and their uncle is their sister.
No,
you
want to
see that?
Butcher's
go to
Creek.
Creek. Yeah, you want to see that? Go to Butcher's Creek.
Yep.
Actually, no. That's LeCay from what I hear.
Listen, those LeCay lot are all right. They're much better than the Butcher's Creek lot, it's got to be said.
Yeah, I've just heard LeCay's, they're all just inbred. But...
Yeah, they're incredibly inbred, but they're at least nice.
Yeah, they're all right.
Yeah, we don't talk about Butcher's Creek.
Who are the two sisters that we met that we thought
were
the butchers?
The redhead and the other one. Yeah. I love those two.
Man, I talked to this hillbilly today out in the swamps, and he told me I was respectable, and I'm welcome in the creek anytime, and he'll never eat me.
Yeah, that.
Yeah,
that's
I certainly trust that one.
You think I'm going to the fucking creek? On me? You got me all messed up. Never.
Bro, they go. They eat that sleepy stew, man.
I seen a human's face stretched out on a dream catcher the other day when I went there. No thanks.
Oh, you probably saw a piece of my back up there too.
Probably.
I don't know why you'd eat somebody. There's like 45 alligators every three steps in the swamp. You can get them anywhere. You gotta eat people.
I have something for you.
Boil it for a while. You're all right. I'm sure humans chewy.
Boiled gator?
Boiled gator.
Hey.
Make it into a gator stew.
You got your back too?
Look at what I bought.
I've never been out
of that one.
Machete.
It's a machete. I also bought a hammer and some knives and another kind of knife. And
did you get that from the shop here?
Fuck your machete.
Maybe. I also have one of those.
Well, we appreciate your patronage.
Right,
over
a little
there.
Bit
Thank
of market
you.
Research here, guys. How much money would you spend on a genuine pirate sword? Like a real pirate sword that was once owned.
What proof is that if it's
quite
a
bit.
Real pirate sword?
Like, there's like a drawing of Blackbeard holding it.
No.
Well, maybe.
Maybe
you have a Valentine. What the fuck?
It depends on the sword. If it was Blackbeard,
those
were
crazy.
Treasure map that we found.
Yeah,
$300 starting.
Whoa!
Should have shot him.
See that?
That's what I did. I don't go anywhere near them without my gun out.
$400.
Now, more money.
Hold on, hold on.
Stop.
Whoa, whoa.
Hold on, let me,
More market research. I got a real question
for
you.
Good RP.
Okay, continue.
Sorry,
I was. I always hate dealing with groups like that because I feel like their RP goes to shit really fast.
Oh,
it doesn't
you
make
don't
any
have
sense.
500.
550.
What the hell?
Man's betting on credit right now.
No, he's betting on my fucking
better
money.
Go to the bank. Betting on credit.
Stop it.
It's alright. I have 100. I could cover that.
Oh my. That does sound
badass.
But
the point
though.
I'm getting is there's interest. Sadie, there's interest. People want the pirate sword.
Fuck yeah.
Gotta remember,
well, it's not every day you come across a genuine pirate sword.
That is true.
But is there really a demand for a genuine pirate sword?
Yes.
From the sounds of it.
I want a fucking pirate sword.
I mean, we're going to have all kinds of cool stuff eventually. We're gonna
I've always heard them talk super fast. I can never understand
frogs.
What they say.
I'll buy a crystal skull from you.
We're going to have our Van Horn buybacks.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a good one. It's where people can come buy back all the guns we stole from them.
Oh.
I like that. I like that. That's good. It's a good idea.
All right, so Puck, about that $150.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to have to work on that, unfortunately.
Well. No Arabian for Joe.
I genuinely wanted to, but then I forgot that I'd
You know what? It's
all
right. It's all right. Why did you buy a wagon?
Because it's really fucking cool.
That is true.
I bought a wagon and then I accidentally sold it.
Yeah,
but it's not a wagon. Jennifer, it's a little buggy. It's the little two-seater buggy.
The buggy is amazing. That is the best way to get around.
It's so quick as shit.
Yeah. It's so fast, and yeah, you can carry two people around. It's really nice. Buggy is the way to go. Is the preferred delivery method for us.
Wait, where is she going? Hold on.
She's running the telegram.
Doesn't hold a lot, though.
Jack, that boy Jack.
Your bond's white knight.
Yep.
Sorry, I had something on my lips.
So where we heading there, Sadie Puck? West Elizabeth, that's where the motherfuckers deserve to be robbed.
Yeah, sure, we can head out there. I gotta get my
Wait, you going to rob bounty hunters?
Anybody, really. I guess if a bounty hunter would be top priority, but they usually roll around in packs of like 8, right? There was like 6 of them there.
Yeah, I don't know why, but they do. They roll out, sometimes roll in a bigger pack.
Well, I mean, if 3 of you are free.
I have no problem going.
I can't guarantee that interaction is going to be just Robin. I'm sorry.
No, shootout's fine with me. I don't care.
Yeah, I'm down for a shootout. I need to prove myself to Joe Legg. I let him down the other night.
That's true. He let me down because I tried to fight 6 people at once. It was really... And they were bounty hunters, too. What were they? Who were they?
Fuck it. I'm getting my shit on.
There you go. What was that son's of bitch's name?
Zane.
No, Zane. It was his bounty hunters that he set me up, that son of a bitch. But I'm out of Sissica now, so we're ready for round 2.
Joe, I'm borrowing your horse. I'll be right back.
All right. Are you getting mine from the stable? Or are you getting yours?
I did try to sell them the wall.
Looks like they're going to have some fun.
If only it was a little earlier.
They never wanted them.
Man.
All right, well, I guess I'm heading to the store. See what's up over there.
Well, I guess we're the remainder people that are here. Over at the parlor on Saturday from 2 to 6, so right before the fights, we're having an open parlor so anybody can come in and play on the table. So if you want to take people's money, you're welcome to come and give it a shot. It's $150 buy-ins. So.
Very nice. I cannot
make this. It's a hefty pun.
Yeah. Well, it's usually private, but I figure
sure
I'll open it up to give everybody a shot and let everybody rotate on the table as they want to. So
I know I've ran into some people saying they want to play cards, so
yeah, it seems to a lot of folks have been wanting to get in there, so I figured I'd make it easy.
Right.
And I figure if I do it right before the fights, then it'll help out the betting at the fights as well. Is you know, get people lubricated. You know,
who's Randy Hudson's move over?
Here comes Jack.
Oh.
Where'd they go?
How did they leave you?
They left me?
Miss Yvonne, so. Could I trouble you for some time to figure out some ordering for the parlor?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely.
Wait, I just need to kind of go through the menu of like what you offer and see,
I believe it.
See what all we can do.
So I do not have access to that bench.
Yeah, absolutely.
I tried to get rid of those reinforced lassos to Law, but they were like, oh, we already got someone up in Valentine, and then I can never find the fucking Law around here.
I'm available to do all that. Do you have your telegram available?
Yeah, give me 2 seconds.
I don't understand why Law doesn't want them, but whatever. You'd think they would.
Jack.
What do you want?
All right, you ready?
You'll need to talk as well, then.
Yes, I am.
So it's J-D-1982.
Yeah. Oh, my God, it's Santa.
So my name is William, last name Hudson, H-U-D-S-O-N.
All right, perfect. So I'll get that menu put together with some prices.
Those are the only ones making lassos?
I'll include bulk purchase item or bulk pricing as well. And then I'll shoot you a telegram, hopefully sometime later tonight.
Okay, yeah, I just need to stock up for Saturday. We're having an event Saturday, so.
Yeah, I'll definitely get that done for you.
All right, excellent. Thank you. I appreciate it. And then, of course, you guys are invited to come over to the parlor from 2 to 6 on Saturday. It'll be open to everybody, so everyone gets a shot at the table, and maybe somebody can take some big money, so.
Oh, wonderful. Nice. Well, yeah. I mean, I did see
the new carpenter
poster,
up
so I hope
in,
you have a wonderful
Annisburg
event, and I will definitely try to make it for you.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to get the word out there. A lot of folks wanted to get on there, so I figured that'd be the best way to
do it.
Hello, how are you? Hello. How's it going? Yeah, just at your leisure on that menu there.
Bye.
I appreciate it.
All right,
sounds good. I need to head back to the Bastille. Y'all have a good one.
You ready? We're running the store.
Slow evening.
Yeah, it's been pretty slow. Not much going on. Oh my fuck. Hey,
sorry
did
about
you?
That.
No,
right.
You're fine. No, yeah. No, hey, good. Did you talk to Alexander?
Not yet. I can get caught up with him though.
Ask him about my telegram I sent him. It'll intrigue you.
The one from a few days ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one's real interesting.
Yeah, very. I thought so myself.
Well, as you can see what you saw with the bounty hunters, that's what we've been fucking dealing with.
Yeah, fuck them, to be honest. I don't know why they're in our fucking town acting like they own the fucking place, but they can see themselves out of it.
Listen, I'm not an outlaw. Never wanted to be an outlaw. They just put me in a bad position, so we had to do what we had to do.
Is it still dark?
Do you like what I said to them?
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure it was good.
Anyway, all right, well, I'll catch up with Alexander, and then you guys need anything, or are you good?
I need to check and see where we're at gun-wise.
Yeah, let me know.
No.
It's a little easier for us to get guns, at least for the next week or so.
Yeah, sounds good.
I had a question in reference to that, because we've been trying to get a hold of some other stuff. David, you know that big order that we tried to put in elsewhere?
Yeah.
And we just can't come up with them.
Oh, so. I already talked to them about that. Well, I talked to Alexander about it.
Oh, okay. All right, so that was part of what you were doing. All right. But, so we're trying to get all those back.
Phones are the worst.
Just that fella's not been around. I think he threw them all in a wagon. But that's been a struggle there. But, all right, well, sounds like you got it covered then. So we'll just try to recover all that from that other fella. All
right, sounds good.
Appreciate you. If you guys need anything, let me know.
Will do.
Willie. So I've been thinking.
Uh-huh.
really thought about becoming a lawyer. And I wonder if I could become a lawyer and keep a gun store. Just do the lawyering on the side, you know?
Yeah, I think it's just a, you just get a little, cart, don't you? I don't think it really offers you anything else.
You know, I don't know. I need to ask. I'd like to be a lawyer.
Most lawyers are just private citizens that do other things, right? So I'd imagine it's probably not like being a judge or anything. You know, that'd take your full,
No, I wouldn't mind to come up and be a judge. That'd be kind of dope.
Yeah, I've been flirting with rezoning the parlor upstairs and turning it into like an actual private club or something instead of what it is now.
That'd be cool. What are you thinking about it?
I'm just trying to expand things a little bit and make it a little bit easier. Like having to try and work with people just to get, food and drinks and that sort of thing. I can't work with anybody. Like everybody's just, so slow on everything.
Yeah.
It's like nobody wants to make any money or something. I don't understand what it is.
I don't get it. I'm in the business of making money. That's all I love to do.
Yeah, it's just I don't know. It's just hard. So it'd be easier if I just had my own. I could fill out my own menu and carry my own things. And, that'd be nice to have. My own little selection of stuff up there. But in order to do that, then I would have to be an actual. Because right now it's just a house, right? It's just treated like a house, so I can have another job, and there's nothing stopping me there. But I feel like also if it was actual. If it was actually open and it was actually, on the map, so to speak, then it would be a little bit easier to do things.
Yeah. I'm sure we can make that happen. Sure.
Yeah, I would have to, I wouldn't be able to work over there with Hawthorne anymore. I wouldn't be able to get into any of the, do any of the stuff where, we could obviously run shipments and do that sort of thing, but he'd be there alone doing everything else. So.
Yeah, that's kind of how I feel here. My brothers aren't around too much, so I feel like I'm doing a lot of it myself. It's just kind of demanding. The money's great, don't get me wrong, but man, it's a lot for sure. Yeah.
You get a couple days behind, and then all of a sudden, you don't know what you're missing.
I know. That's what it seems like.
I mean, I just restocked that place this morning, and we're already out of every single knife that we put in there. And I mean, we've sold. Probably $200-something of knives alone today. So,
yeah, my knives here are going quick too. So are my binoculars. I'm surprised they're going that quick, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what that is. Yeah, we've just been putting a whole bunch of them in there, and
I can't keep up with guns either. See if I'm short on any. I just restocked for the storm.
So are they able to get the sawed-offs? Are they able to do that now? Or
they say no. That they think the only people that can get them are at the... down a bolt action. Is at the... hand of armor rifle. The pawn shop here in town. Apparently they're the only ones that can get them.
That's just... Well, even then, I went in there
don't
to ask
talk
them,
to him.
And they didn't even have any.
He'd probably be down for.
So that was like, I saw one in there and it was like $55. And then I asked him, hey, do you get any more of those? Sort of thing. Just trying to work a deal with them. And they're like, no, somebody just pawned that one.
Huh.
So I don't even know if that's the, I don't know. Now I do have I'm supposed to have a meeting with the pawn shop fella out there in Blackwater. So if that's the case, if that's what you're hearing, then maybe I can work a deal with him for some stuff and get some stuff in through him at a decent price.
That would be pretty cool. I think you should do that. Yeah, I need to find someone with... First of all, I need to get those fucking shotguns back from Valentine. That's what I need to do. Second, I need to figure out where the fuck to get them made, because I keep having people coming in here asking for them, but I can't fucking find anyone to make them.
Well, yeah, that was ultimately the issue that we ran into. And, we've been trying to get those back, but it's like he's just not been awake. So I don't know. We'll try to reach out to him in other ways and see if we can't get him.
Yeah, that's fine.
Because I don't think his worker. We've talked with her, and she doesn't have access to him. So I think they're in one of his wagons.
Probably, or it's in his big supply.
Well, because he loaded them up, and we followed him out there for him to go make them. So he had them loaded up, and then that's when we got the message basically saying that, yeah, he can't do it anymore.
Interesting.
So, I mean, yeah, we watched him load them up and take them. He just was never able to fill the order there, so...
I'm not going to lie, I really thought about going over there and buying those four he had in the pawn shop and then coming back here and selling them for 45.
What are they in the pawn shop for?
40.
I mean, hey, you only make $5 on them. I mean, you ain't losing nothing.
Yeah.
Probably sound like you got to travel very far. It's probably worth $20 to walk over there and get them.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to put a bigger variety in the store than what other stores have. It's the biggest thing. But man, it's hard to keep up.
Yeah, you're already above and beyond on those. Most places have probably 5 or 6 less than what you've got in there.
I just like to keep it stocked, you know. Plenty of ammo, plenty of guns, plenty of other options, lassos, binoculars, knives. You know, the basic right. thing like our hunters need, because a lot of the hunters come in here and buy shit, so if I can help them with whatever they have, then they're more apt to come back, you know?
Yeah, that is true. That is true.
He's an Aussie? True. But, I don't know. I'm really weighing in on this lawyer thing. That would be cool is if I could keep the gun store and be a lawyer. That'd be pretty cool. But I need to talk with the DOJ and see how that works.
Yeah, I don't see any reason why you wouldn't be able to. You probably just couldn't take any case like that has to do with, you know, the business or anything like that, right?
Right, that would be my... I think that'd be the only stipulation.
Now, obviously, you could defend yourself, but, you know, you just wouldn't be able to affect... You know, legislation for businesses as a whole or something, you know, might be one of those deals. Because I thought about the same thing as well, was, you know, just adding something on there to, you know, I meet a lot of shady people in the parlor and everything. So it's, you know, might be good for relationships to be able to represent some fellas. But who's to say? But yeah, that's a good thing to track down there. Let me know what you find out on it, because I'd definitely be interested as well.
Well, we'll let you know. Surely I could do it. Lassie is an awesome.
Yeah.
Who's Lassie? Is that you?
How's it going?
Howdy, Phil.
Oh, how did that? I was wondering if I could buy some rifle ammo.
Yeah, of course. Mr. Billy here can help you get squared away. He's got everything you need. He's got all the information for you. So any questions you have?
All right. Thank you, kind.
Oh, you're very welcome.
All right. Well, I'm going to head up and head to bed. I didn't intend on being around too long this evening.
No, already. So, that was good.
He got you all squared away on all those other orders that you had, right?
Yeah, I'm about to have to put in another one, though. I got my 500 steel from him, but I'm going to need... I might put in for, like, 25 binoculars, 25 knives.
Okay, I'll get started on that for you in the morning, then. Right. I'll go ahead and make a slip for it, and yeah, I'll get started on them.
Y'all have a good one.
Yeah, thanks, buddy. Yeah, so we'll get that knocked out, and yeah, I'll have that ready to deliver tomorrow. Just knives and binoculars.
Yeah.
Any particular knife, or
no? Just a regular knife. I don't want to take away from you all either. So just the regular knife and 25 binoculars, 25 knives.
Okay. Yeah, we can do that. All right then. Yeah, I'll make a slip for it. And I'll get it going in the morning. All right.
Alrighty, appreciate you, buddy. We'll make up some guns here.
Alrighty.
Oh, you are. Hi, Evelyn. Danny the Carpenter. That's who I thought you were, but I was like, I don't want to lie. Lassie, yes, he has all my shotguns right now. Yeah, he's got like 12 of them. He needs to give them back. Just gonna... something Boy, that was a struggle. Gotta get up early, man. I do too, actually. Welcome in, everyone. Making some guns. Gotta refill the store here. A little low. Not really low. I'm just missing some. My OCD's kicking in, chat. Everything's gotta be a 10. Need to put up my bolt action so I don't put it in the damn store. Oh, it's already in there. Just kidding. Where's that varmer? There it is. Perfect. Run down. I know my OCD is so bad. I'm always like, oh my gosh, I'm down again. I gotta restock it. Or my ammo's less than 100. I gotta restock it. Terrible about it. I'll literally stop everything I'm doing and go redo it. Just fuck. I know some stores I go into and they have like one of everything or like one of this, one of that, and I'm like, oh, I can't do it. Oh my gosh. Or they don't have every gun in there. I'm like, oh my goodness. I freaked out yesterday. I didn't have any varmint rifles in there and I don't know how long it was empty. But apparently that's not a gun that I checked for and it was empty. So I immediately had to put 10 in there. Thank you, oh my goodness. Chat, I need help. Let's, not a bad suit. Not bad. I don't know why it's brown. Alright. I need something real nice, chat. Like, real nice. I like these. These are good. These are good. I feel like a good black. It's a good black. Okay, digging it. Do we go all black shoes? Oxford's nice. Is that like a color? I don't want leather. The real question is, should I leave the bottom white? Or should I change it? I feel like I should change it. To like an all black. Oh, the style of the shoe? I'm terrible. Which one is it? Were my toes just sticking? Oh, that. What are these? It's a cool little, yeah. I'm kind of just looking for like an all black. Why are my shoes this color? What is going on? Well, of course they changed as soon as I fucking. Definitely gotta have the nice coat. Oh, perfect. Check out some vest here. You know what I really like? I don't know why I'm so obsessed with this vest, chat, but I really like this one. This one. I really like it. I don't know why I like it so much, but I like it. Okay. I go gold or silver here. I'm a businessman. I gotta look spiffy all the time. That's too much gold. Should I go like a silver though? I am insane to me. See, you gotta look good all the time. That's like a blue. I don't want that. I just want like a bright silver here. Not purple. That looks silver enough, Chet. I could never. Valentine, I would. My OCD would. Should I go all black here? That's a real question. Should I stay all black or should I change the tint? To like. What's 6 do? Oh, I bet 6 is my back. What just happened? Why is it gone? This can't be happening. Oh, poof. Yeah, I couldn't do that. I would probably lose my mind. Oh, that's a good silver. I knew what you meant. I feel like this is a good silver. Absolutely. I love Saint Denis. I'm not gonna lie. Some people hate it, but I love it. Fucking need some color to me, though. Does this look good, chat? That's what I need to know. Does this look good? Should we change something? Valentine is a good town. You like it? Alright. That's what it's gonna be. Is it gonna do me dirty like that? 2, 3. So I got this gray suit, brown suit, black suit. Yes. I start to change it up. I really like the brown and the navy I wear, but I feel like I always wear it. We're good now, chat. We are good now. I think the black fits so well with Saint Denis, too. Just looks so good. I think the navy looks really good, but I feel like I should go back and edit this vest to match the silver to match the belt buckle. I feel like they're two different colors. I'm going to. Most of these kicking in. Oh, that's not the fucking door. What am I doing? There we go. Look at that. I knew I should come back. Yeah, I have to like get off and like put my boots on and put them back on. It does that to me as well. When I was in Saint Denis, or not Saint Denis, when I was in Rhodes, I could not stand to wear black because you could see all the red. Nope, I do it too. It's weird. I think it has to do with the horse script. Hey there, Villa. Sorry, I didn't see you when I came in. My apologies. My name's David. Dave McCarthy. I'm the gun store here. Hey, what's your name? Oh, nice to meet you. Oh, yeah, Billy. Hope he's treating you well. Good deal, good deal. Are you new here? Oh, well, nice to meet you. Glad you're here. And, welcome, Saint Denis. Oh, really? Well, good. If you never need anything, just make sure you come on by and we'll get you squared away here. Oh, anytime. What kind of revolver are you thinking? Oh, okay. It's a pretty good gun. Enjoying myself. I do have the Navy crossovers, which is what I have here. It's a little on the expensive side, though, because they're a little customized. About 45. Yeah, absolutely. I appreciate you coming in. And like I said, if you ever need anything, you just let me know. Huh? I gotta make a Schofield. Can't see ball one. Good thing is, he did not buy the gun that... Me as well. And thanks for coming and hanging out. Have a good night. Make sure you join back in. We'll be hopefully streaming again tomorrow. Hopefully. All right, Chad. I think it's going to be it for me tonight as well.